go to the controversial parts, specifically the letter of Paul to the Galatians. Pakita natin yung graphics number one. Actually, shocking din to a lot of people when the first time they saw this portion. Galatians chapter 1 verse 6, it says, "Sobrang na-shock ako sa inyo. Ang dali niyo naman tinalikuran ng Diyos. Imagine, sobrang bait niya at pinadala niya si Christ sa atin. Ang Diyos niyo mismo ang pumili sa inyo. Tapos ngayon, ine-entertain niyo ang ibang gospel."
Mm-hmm.
So, why translated that way?
Well, because we, as I've said, we want to translate it in the way that people will actually say it in their own words, but faithful to the Greek text. It has to be faithful. Now, that's why it is a heterogeneous language. It uses heterogeneous language. It will make use of English words if it will make the rendering natural, because that's very important. That is why here in chapter 1, verse 6 of Galatians, you have a mixing. You have a mixing, the use of both English and Filipino, because this is the natural way to say it. If you look at the meaning of the of this verse in the Greek text, this is the natural way to say it.
But what are the pitfalls? Because some people might be thinking we're accommodating too much the so-called conversational modern language when it comes to translating a very important book. In this case, we're talking about to the believers, the actual Word of God.
Yeah. Well, that is always our main concern, accuracy. And so we have that's why I said we have a set of principles. We cannot go beyond a certain parameter in our dynamic translations. There is, even if there is a kind of freedom, because we are basing it on, we are using meaning as our basis, there's a parameter. We cannot go beyond that.
About the